So we will directly go to the program. I want to give time to our brother Augustine to talk about justice for Kartika. So we will directly go to the program. I want to give time to our brother Augustine to talk about justice for Kartika.
Good evening, everybody. It's nice to be a part of this program, a part of this Awaken India movement. And before we start the program, I would just like to highlight some of the guidelines issued by the National Alliance for Health, Safety and Freedom under the aegis of AIM. So these are the missions and visions of this AIM and National Health Alliance for Safety and Freedom. Here is the mission and vision is, here is an urgent need to stop our dependency and condition, focus on reductionist, compartmentalized healthcare system. Healthcare system and practices as a policy and in the day-to-day decision making. We have allocated too much time, our precious time, energy and resources to this monopolistic and profit-hungry domain and practices. The current predominant reductionist approach towards health has failed to pay adherence to the Hippocratic oath, the principle of first, do no harm. It not only ignores it, but also violates health safety by means of deception and coercion. It hinders an individual from making an educated decision by not providing informed consent and freedom of choice. This is a gross violation of bioethics, laws and individual liberties and rights, thus abusing the basic tenets of life, freedom, sovereignty and security. It is high time to shift our focus and time and energy to instinct
direct our resources towards functional, holistic and integrative approaches to health and life science. An urgent brake will be applied to the current misuse and abuse all life forms and all vital forces of life. Genuine healing cannot be achieved without detoxification and returning back to nature, without the simultaneous consideration of body, mind and spirit. Not a new world order, but a new divine earth is in the making. Not the great reset, but the great awakening. Not enslavement of the human subconscious mind, but liberation of the collective consciousness is a sign of times. So as an appeal and responsible individual organization, we have come to a juncture where we have only two choices. Freedom, that is sovereign and symbiotic with nature, or slavery via medical, digital and climate deception. Which is your choice? Or it is your choice by the action you choose. You can be fooled by the oppressor logo, build back better and support the technocratic takeover of humanity. Or you can join forces with like-hearted others to better team them down and reject the slave masters, the likes of the owners of BlackRock and Vanguard corporations, attempt to turn humans into automations. Take courage and make a firm decision to help humanity by raising your own individual consciousness. Take responsibility for your own karmic quotient. This will in turn support the entire collective consciousness in taking a great leap forward. Your decision counts, the life and all your companions in need of you. Are you in? Great minds and hearts are already succeeding in this endeavor. Please join us now. I would like to also highlight on this justice for Artica as issued by the AIM. Young leaves are precious, so please be cautious. The introduction and background. A campaign to run on physical, digital and legal front to create awareness on the issue and the crucial issue of COVID vaccines, to empower the public through education and safety mechanism provided via medical, legal and bioethical protocols. The COVID vaccine has technically been given conditional approval of restricted and use under emergency situation. To empower the public through education on safety mechanism, but it is marketed as National COVID Vaccination Program. I would repeat this again. The COVID vaccine has technically been given conditional approval for restricted use under emergency situation, but it is being marketed as national COVID vaccination program by the government of India, aiming at over zillion universal immunization covering every democratic group, including India youths, with this experimental vaccine, which has not completed its clinical trial and lack credible and conclusive safety, efficacy, and risk-benefit empirical data. The COVID vaccine is being run in the name of an emergency health situation. But contradicting this, serological surveys conducted by ICMR at the pan-India level prove that more than two-thirds of the Indian population have already achieved national herd immunity from COVID-19. And this percentage has risen in study after study. Also, infection fatality rate is less than 0.1%, which is same as in the case of seasonal flu. This clearly questions the need of any vaccine and the current drive to force as many of these so-called vaccinations on an ignorant public. Propaganda and theatrics via media by repetitive use of disinformation, deception, and fear-mongering has led to the situation where we are standing today, wherein the vaccination drive with this experimental vaccine is being pushed as the need of the hour, instigating public pressure and demand. The public psyche, including those in the medical profession, has been deceived through media propaganda and lies. The genuine of the existence of a genuine threat in the form of a contagious and deadly pathogen has not been scientifically proven during the entire pandemic for the sake of COVID-19. A scientific approach seeking any causal relationship along with statistical correlations has not been followed. Hence, the policy decision to universally and overzealously administer the COVID vaccine is highly questionable. The prestigious Salk Institute, founded by vaccine pioneers Jonas Salk, has authored and published scientific article revealing that SARS-CoV-2 spike protein is what actually causing vascular damage in COVID patients and COVID vaccine recipients, promoting strokes, heart attacks, migraines, blood clots, and other harmful reactions that have killed thousands of Americans. Critically, all COVID vaccine brands currently in widespread use either inject pains with the spike proteins or instruct the patient's own body to manufacture spike proteins and release them in their own blood. This floods the patient's body with the very spike protein that the Salk Institute has identified as the smoking gun cause of vascular damage and related events, such as blood clots, which are killing many people who take the vaccines. Every medical decision, protocol, and health emergency assessment come policy must fulfill the scientific principle of causal relationship along with justified statistical correlations that are guided by bioethics. In the COVID vaccination drive, the whole narrative and conclusion being made that benefit outweighs risks is not only scientific but also unethical and patently false. All this seems as a deliberate fraud being perpetrated to create a medical police state rule and dictated by pharma interests, which transfers a nation's sovereignty, security, and integrity into the hands of corporates, operators, and owners of the World Economic Forum, as declared documented in its officially policy of the Great Reset. Sorry. A few vaccine deaths have been covered by the media. Justice for Kartika. We lost our beloved daughters Kauranya, age 20, and Vithayaka, age 18, to post-COVID vaccine complication. Our deepest desire is to save lives by transforming people to understand the risks involved in COVID vaccine before vaccinating their children. Parents need to learn about the known adverse effects and its severity before deciding to vaccinate their children. And our appeal, our kids, our future, all information regarding COVID vaccine in the form of a fact sheet should be provided to the recipients, parents, prior to the vaccination. The fact sheet to include the following: ingredients of the vaccine with its toxicity and contraindications, the known risks associated with the vaccine to include mild, moderate, and severe adverse reactions, like life-threatening and fatal blood clots, and stating that these events can occur anytime after vaccination, as the clinical trials are still going on. That some of these threatening adverse reactions could be caught early with some blood tests if performed within 4 to 5 days of getting the vaccine. The doctors and public should be educated about the signs and symptoms to be noted in the vaccinated, so as to do timely diagnosis and treatment of adverse effects. The same information should be prominently communicated in understandable and terminology at the government sites and PR campaigns, vaccination centers, and during door-to-door or near-to-door vaccination drive. Be transparent, no heartbroken parents. All advertisements and of vaccination should inform that there may occur severe and unexpected adverse effects after taking COVID injection. Unconditional and misleading statements such as vaccines are completely false should not be used. Vaccination to be carried out after informed consent. In the COWIN app, while registering for a vaccination, the above fact sheet should be displayed and the user is required to press I have read and understood. There is a possibility that some people are not eligible to take the COVID vaccine due to allergies or various pre-existing health conditions, including presence of sufficient antibodies. Information of the tests that can be taken to assess this should be widely disseminated. Coercion and forced to vaccinate using direct or indirect mandates, compulsion for employers, educational institutions should be stopped immediately as it is unlawful and no fundamental rights to be denied to those who choose not to vaccinate. Helpline number 1075 should accept complaint or coercion or discrimination faced by any on the basis of his or her vaccination status. This should be forwarded to local police station. We appeal to suspend the COVID vaccination program for children, as there is a lot of proven and found adverse reactions already happening in young adults, and the fact that more than 2/3 of Indian population have already gained the natural herd immunity for COVID-19, and its infection fatality rate has found to be less than 0.5%, which is equivalent to seasonal flu. Thus, even continuing the clinical trial in children is unethical and should be stopped. More than a dozen developed countries in the world have stopped using AstraZeneca, as called Covishield in India, for some people under 40 years due to the proven and known fatal risks due to blood clot. The same policy should be followed in our country for the safety and lives of the young people. Today, we wish to embark on a campaign to demand justice for Kartika. It is a campaign to raise awareness, especially on severe adverse events and fatal injuries in young people post taking the COVID injection. We are deeply concerned about the vaccine clinical trial for children currently being carried out, which is completely unethical. We fear that it may soon receive emergency usage authorization. So this is ইটো আছে আমি খানকে গাইডলাইনস ইখান পঠাই দি আছে ইটো আপোনানকে জনাই দিছে ইটো মৰম পৰা আমি খানকে আজি এটা প্ৰগ্ৰামতে পাৰ্টিচিপেট কৰা খান মন দিগিনে ফাৰ্ষ্ট লাষ্ট টাক প্ৰগ্ৰামতে ইয়াৰো দুশা কথা বেছি ক'বলৈ আছে ইটো আন সব শুনি দিবি কইনা আপুনি আন সবকে এপিল কৰিছে থেংক ইউ